5月13日，少数族裔媒体服务机构 EMS 召开网络会议，就罗素韦德案对亚太裔妇女的影响，邀请国会议员赵美心、国会议员 Pramila Jayapal、 全国亚太裔美国妇女论坛执行董事乔莫罗、 Heart Women and Girls 联合执行董事 Eliza Kasmi、 亚美公益促进中心执行董事杨从远五位嘉宾，多角度剖析该案对亚太妇女未来的影响。触发罗素韦德案轩然大波的原因是一份美国高等法院的草案遭到泄露。近期网络上流传的一份被泄露的法院草案显示，保守派法官塞缪尔·阿利托称1973年罗素韦德案的裁决是一个严重错误，应该被推翻。如果罗素韦德案被推翻，那么堕胎在美国至少十几个州将即刻成为非法。在当天的会议中，有多位嘉宾对此发表看法。曾经推动妇女健康保护法防止保守州堕胎禁令的赵美心表示，
And we know protecting abortion rights is the majority opinion of Americans. For nearly 50 years in poll after poll, a majority of Americans support access to abortion. So for that reason, we marched to the Senate, making sure that as the senators debated if they wanted to stand up for our right to choose what to do with our own bodies, that they would hear from us. So even though the vote on Wednesday was not successful,It was not the end. It was just the beginning. We are just getting started in our fight to protect abortion access. And I am especially invested in this fight as I know that the impacts of these abortion bans are felt most acutely by communities of color, including the Asian American Pacific Islander community.
来自华盛顿州的国会议员 Pramila Jayapal 指出，近期与芝加哥大学的联合调查中显示，约 35% 亚太裔女性怀孕时曾流产，在所有种族中占比第二高。而超过 85% 的亚太裔女性还认为，在生殖健康方面，她们应该有权利做出自己的选择。对亚太裔来说，堕胎不是一个容易的选择，尤其背负着文化耻辱的压力。她并提到，美国女权还有很长的路要走，像是避孕药取得、健保系统的改善、女性带薪休假等问题。
I have to say that the integrity of the Supreme Court is absolutely the issue now, because you know this is one of the very important institutions of our democracy, and unfortunately, the integrity of the Supreme Court has been really, really severely damaged, and that means our democracy is damaged and.You know, we don't even have a standard code of conduct of ethics for Supreme Court justices. And it isn't just Roe. I mean, even before this, when it relates to judges writing written.
与会专家纷纷表示，如果罗素韦德案被推翻，少数族裔女性合法堕胎的权利将被剥夺，对少数族裔妇女的影响更为严重和深远。据数据显示，收入较低的少数族裔女性通常更有可能寻求堕胎。美国 61% 的堕胎者来自少数族裔，这些女性如失去合法的堕胎渠道，将对他们的生活产生沉重冲击。全美电视台记者洛杉矶采访报道。